So we're going to call this one 9.1.5B. There wasn't a lesson before. This is just more review to make sure you're solid. Okay? So you know how to do those two. First quarter, I never got an opportunity to teach you how to find the area. So here's the formula for it. Plug it in, get the answer, you'll be good to go. It's just a formula. You can plug in. You know how to do the review. Okay? Remember, when we're simplifying, we might want to change it to exponential. We're trying to find what to the third power gives us 125, and simplifying from there. In this one, remember, you can't have a radical in the denominator. You know what? I think I'll actually do this one just because I'd rather you make sure you're going to get this one right. Okay? Oops. So I know that 125 is the same thing as 5 cubed. Now x to the 6th, y to the 9th, all to the 1/3. So that would be 5 to the 1st, x squared, y cubed, which is 5x squared, y cubed. I could have also done it a different way. I'm trying to find piles of 3. So that would be 5, 5, 5. That's a pile of 3. X, 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 x. Two more piles, nothing left over. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 1, 2, 3 piles. If it was y to the 10th, your answer, let's say that said y to the 10th, then it would also be rad y, because you would have cube root of rad y, because you would have 1 left over. Okay? All right, we went over that one. This one, use Desmos to get the answer. This one, they want you to create an equation. So remember we did that in chapter 8. You find the zeros. Oh, I put the hint right there. And then pick a point and plug it in. So there's your hint right there. I'll highlight it to remind you about the hint. In this one, they want you to find the inverse. You're good at finding the inverse. And then find the domain and range. If you're struggling with that, you can always use Desmos to help you. Okay? And this one, they want you to give information. This one, sorry, my dog freaks out for no reason. What you want to do is you're going to take, see how the F is closest to the X? You're going to take F, and you're going to put it in there for X, and then simplify it. And that's your last homework.